The next abstract thinking skill is seeing very clearly the difference between fact, claim, and value. In my experience, that a lot of people don't know the differences in their everyday practical thing. So, value is something that it's about preference. So it cannot be true or false, right or wrong. It is your opinion. So you can say that something is right or wrong, but you are not right or wrong judging something in any way. So this is about, I like it, I dislike it, it's fantastic, it's beautiful, it's ugly, this is value. Fact is subjective, because something is fact for me, but it's not fact for you. So let's assume that my memory is okay. So today I had tomato for breakfast. So this is a fact for me, because I experienced this. But if I say this to you, that my breakfast was tomato, then it is a claim from your perspective that I claim that I had tomato, but you were not there and you just choose to believe me or not to believe me. So a claim is a statement that can be, from a person's perspective, true or false. And a fact is something that the person who evaluates that statement can know for sure that it's true or false, because that person had a first-hand experience. So for example, my emotion is a fact, or what I think that is a fact, except if it's a value. But for you, when you think that you try to read my mind, then that is a claim if you say anything about my mind, that, oh, I'm sure that you like it. Now, this is a claim, because maybe I like it, maybe I don't like it, but you cannot know this. That if I say, oh, I like it, it is a fact for me. I mean, assume that I don't like that. It's a fact because I can know what's happening in my mind, but you can never know. Even if I say that I like it, and the other person, the statement that, oh, Zoltan likes it. No, it's a claim for that person, because maybe I lied to the person and doesn't know my mental state. So there are a lot of categories, like believing in something, mind reading, or making logical conclusions, or just accepting everything in that face value. So for example, my birthday, when I was born, which day, for me, it is a claim, okay? And actually it's basically almost for everybody, except my parents. So the people who were there and experienced that actually I was born on that day. But let's say maybe I was kidnapped as a baby, or maybe they make a fake entry in the registry, the birth registry, and then actually my birthday maybe is a different day. So I cannot know when I was born, but let's say my mother, my father can. So, and it also comes to the evidence. What is evidence? So evidence is basically what a person chooses to believe it's true. So it's sort of subjective. So you see a fingerprint on the murder weapon, and then you make a statement that that person who has the fingerprint on the weapon is the killer. No, this is a claim, it's not a fact. Because I don't know whether it's really true that it's his or her fingerprint, and even if it's his or her fingerprint, well, it doesn't necessarily mean that that person pulled the trigger, and maybe it's also not that the bullet killed that person. Maybe you find a bullet, but does this bullet belong to? So there can be a lot of reason that something that for a lot of people seems as an evidence, as a proof, automatically, actually it's not. It always comes through the mind that accepts this as an evidence. So these are that knowing what is evidence, what is value, claim, facts, it's a very important abstract thinking tool, because if you don't know what you are based on your theories or approach on, then you will come up with a wrong conclusion. So let's say that you use statistical data to come up with a model about some social issues. And if you regard the statistical data as true and facts, then you'll be very confident to base your thing. But let's say that you find out later that the data was totally false. Let's say that many societies, when they collect statistical data, people lie. So if you based on lies your theory, then your abstract thinking came up with a wrong conclusion because you based on the facts. So it's abstract thinking a lot of times based on real life data and experiences. And if you accept, let's say, data as fact and you create a model, then you have a big problem.